nostri spettatori sono sicuramente.
I am sure the Worldbot spectators will remember that some time ago, in a past episode, we presented a range of models from the Ranieri International Shipyard. They were the Atlantis models from 20 to 26 feet and two models from the Voyager range. Let's have a look at the second part of this episode and at these new models. Dear friends of Yacht and Sail, today we are in the beautiful Gulf of Squillace in Soverato to test the various new products of the Ranieri International Shipyard. Let's watch the sea trials together. All the boats of the Ranieri International Shipyard are provided with a CE certification and an ISO quality certification, which proves that these boats have been built with high quality materials and first-rate processing techniques. This is the case of this new model, the Atlantis 24, a 7.10-meter day cruiser that can be powered up to 300 HP and can host up to 9 passengers. You can board the Atlantis 24 both from the stern and the bow, thanks to a thick footboard and to a well-built anchor locker. Here we also find two large bits. I want you to notice also the high-quality steel elements. The Ranieri International Shipyard pays attention to each detail. You can see this from the perfectly installed deck outfit and the onboard upholstery. These are closed-cell foam cushions, and the upholstery is handmade with technical materials and can be customized to the owner's taste. The console is in a central position and the steering wheel is located on the keel line. The windshield protects both the pilot and the co-pilot. The customer can customize the console to his favorite color and its instruments are very easy to read thanks to their correct tilt. A smoky black door leads to the board cabin. I want you to notice the white and oak furniture and the lacquered top that matches with the internal upholstery. You can also choose a deluxe version with separate toilet. Like all boats in the Atlantis range, also the Atlantis 24 features the handy side pockets. These are fiberglass and solid thick finished pockets. You can customize by choosing your favorite metallic paint color. Atlantis 24 is 7.10 meter long and 2.55 meter wide and can feature a fully equipped kitchen. Here in the central furniture there is a sink and you can put a grill here and a fridge underneath. At stern, there is a sofa that can comfortably accommodate three guests. Under the pads, we find a roomy locker where you can store even the bulkiest equipment. At the very end of the stern, there are two well-sized bits, the bathing ladder and a shower. Here we see a 225 HP Honda engine, but this boat can install up to 300 HP. All the Ranieri International Shipyard boats are distinguished for their modern design with slender lines and squared corners, a design that makes these boats really sporty. Pilot station is comfortable, thanks to a well-shaped seat and the correct position of the wheel and the throttle that are aligned with the wheel and therefore very handy. But let's start the boat test now.
La
This Atlantis 24 is equipped with a 225 HP Honda engine, and at 2000 revs per minute we are traveling at 7 knots, still in displacement mode. Now I'm going to speed up and get a boat on the plane. The minimum plane is at 3000 revs per minute and 14 knots. I'll step on the gas now. We have to adjust the trim a little. All the Rainier International boats are equipped with a central redan, therefore the boat must be trimmed properly. At 4000 revs per minute we find the ideal cruising speed. We are traveling at 27 knots. But now let's speed up to find the top performance of the Atlantis 24. We immediately reach 6000 revs per minute, and according to the GPS, we are at 42 knots. I'll slow down a little now to try a left turn. The boat responds immediately. Steering is smooth, safe, and prompt at the same time. Now I am going to check the behavior of the boat also on a starboard turn. The boat steers immediately. It can perform a 360-degree turn in quite a small place. The Atlantis 24 has really impressed me. It's a fast, agile and safe boat, ideal for boat camping thanks to its cozy cabin. Always remember to use caution at sea, so don't forget to have a look at the weather forecast before leaving.
One of the most interesting Rainier International new models of the 2012 range is the Atlantis 26, a 7.60-meter day cruiser that can be powered up to 400 HP with either one or two engines. But let's find out more about it. At the far end of the stern, there is a bathing ladder, a shower, and two bits useful for docking. These generous platforms have been skillfully built by the yard to easily get on and off board, and the roomy locker enables to complete the overturn of the outboard engine. You get on board safely thanks to two handrails located here, and guests can comfortably sit on the big sofa located astern. Under the sofa there is a large technical locker which houses all the devices and the bulkiest equipment. The floor surface is generous and it has been furnished with compact furniture that can be used both as leaning post and kitchen furniture. When you open it, you find a standard design sink, and next to it you can put a handy gas cooker. The shipyard pays a lot of attention to safety, and this is shown by this high guardrail and the numerous handrails located throughout the boat. In this position, we can appreciate many interesting details. First of all, the material quality. Look at this shiny fiberglass, which proves that it is a quality fiberglass. Then also the windshield border is very sporty and matches the boat line. On the bow, there is a generous sun deck that can accommodate two guests. At the far end of the boat, besides the usual bits, there is a spacious anchor locker. As you can see, there is no warping hand here, to easily get on and off the boat, also from the bow. The shipyard has also installed a handy tip board.
Even if it is only a 7.60-meter day cruiser, the Atlantis 26 also features a cabin with separate toilet compartment. Let's have a look at it. The cabin is so spacious to host a couple for a short cruise for some days. Also, thanks to the separate toilet equipped with all the comforts.
Grazie anche al bagno separato, dotato di ogni cofano.
Color and design of the console match the sporty line of the boat, and there is also plenty of room to install all the necessary instruments for a safe and comfortable cruising. In this case, the shipyard has installed two Suzuki digital instruments, but it is also possible to install analogical instruments. The console has also plenty of room for a compass and a big plotter. Now I'll wear the safety strap and start the engine. The Atlantis 26 has the same hull as the Shadow 26. This boat is a 2.55-meter wide boat, therefore it is easily trailable. This unit is powered by 300 HP Suzuki engines, and at 1,200 revs per minute we are in displacement mode at 6 knots. At 2,000 revs per minute, we travel at 8 knots, still in displacement mode. I'm stepping on the gas now to get the boat on the plane. The response of the 300 HP Suzuki engine is very prompt. This boat is equipped with a central redone that improves the performance and reduces the fuel consumption because the boat travels on an air cushion. You have to adjust the trim up to 4,000 revs per minute. We are running 28 knots. Well, this is a really interesting cruising speed, as we can run many miles with low fuel consumption and an ideal comfort on board. Slowing down to 3,650 revs per minute, we travel at 25 knots, and this is an ideal convenient cruising speed. You can run many miles with low fuel consumption. The comfort on board is really ideal, and you can easily chat and relax. This new Suzuki engine is really smooth and delivers its power in a gradual way. But let's step on the gas now to find the top performance of the Atlantis 26. I'm adjusting the trim in its full up position. We have reached 6,000 revs per minute and hit 50 knots. It's really incredible, as it's a very stable boat, a really good course stability even at 50 knots. Now I slow down to 40 knots, about 5,000 revs per minute, trim slightly down to adjust the balance, and I try a left turn. It only takes a gentle touch of the wheel to steer immediately. The hull has been skillfully designed. Now I'll try to turn to starboard. Look, you just need to touch the wheel gently to steer. The Atlantis 26 has proven a fast and agile boat. Thanks to its central redone, its fuel consumption is quite low. Always remember to use caution at sea, so keep your wrist strap always fastened.
Il
Today, the Ranieri International Shipyard will present you the Voyager 26S, an 8.10-meter open that integrates the Voyager line. It can be powered up to 400 HP with bi- and mono engines. At bow, the Voyager 26S features a big, finely refined teak harpoon, which is really comfortable as it has an integrated ladder to get on and off the boat even when you are on the beach. Besides the harpoon with the ladder, we also find two handy bits and an anchor locker. Ahead, this new model of the Ranieri International Shipyard features a spacious sunbathing area where five guests can comfortably lie. Under the closed cell phone cushions, there are three huge lockers where you can store even the bulkiest equipment, such as diving equipment, including the oxygen tanks. There is also a table where you can have lunch with your friends. The boat has slender lines and a definitely sporty design. There is a central console and a seat facing the sea with two useful handles. Design and safety merge. The windshield border can also be used as a handrail. The console is also equipped with a toilet / changing room you can access by opening this sliding door. This area has generous headroom where you can stand. It also features a marine water closet. Here we can also find a drawer fridge. Open boats are used especially during the warm season. Therefore, it is advisable to install a canopy with a stainless steel frame which matches with the onboard upholstery and that can also be customized to the owner's taste. Besides the canopy, a further useful element on board is an equipped kitchen. The shipyard has installed one here, in this cabinet. There is also used a stand-up seat. It can be easily opened. Here we find a design sink and next to it you can install a grill and a fridge underneath. The boat is equipped with a handrail and a guardrail all along its outer edge to hold on to in case of moderate sea. Aft, we find a comfortable sofa that seats three, under which there is a room equipment locker. The boat's last generation outboard engines are noiseless and reliable, and if you're looking for a faster boat, you can install two 200 HP units. The hydraulic steering is standard, and at the far end of the stern, there's a handy ladder and a shower. Today's marine forecasts in the Gulf of Squillace are excellent for a speed test. The sea is calm. The pilot can easily drive the Voyager 26S thanks to its ergonomic seat. This position provides a very good boat stern visibility. This boat is powered with a 300 HP outboard Suzuki 4-stroke engine, and at 1000 revs per minute we are in a displacement mode at 7.5 knots speed. Now I'm going to speed up to get the boat on the plane. The controls are very reactive. This is a definitely fast and responsive boat. The console is also very beautiful, and the onboard instruments are easy to read thanks to their right inclination. There is also plenty of room for a big plotter and a compass. The Voyager 26S has proven to be an enjoyable and easy to drive boat, ideal for daily cruises. The toilet / changing room located in a central position is also a very interesting feature of this boat.